Previously on RVlicious.
You're hearing a noise? What? False?
Yeah. You want me to describe something undescribable?
Up in, babe, we're going.
Woohoo!
Penelope, she's a 1983. Well, you know friends from the Netherlands, bad, bad, I'm Penelope, and I'm taking pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves driving till the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe.
Subscribe. Good morning, buddies. Look, and have you. What? You think what? Really? Is that the famous Living in a Camper channel? From the Netherlands? Is it Yuki? Is it Yuki? Is it the most famous camper truck of the Netherlands? Yes, it is. Well, if that is Yuki, then we must be...
RVlicious.
RVlicious. Look at the view, buddies. Look at the view. We're in Ekrum, in Frostland. We had a nice pleasant evening together, and afternoon.
Yes, we did.
And we tasted the durian for the first time. It's the king of the fruits, according to Herman. And if you want to see how that went, go to their channel, we put the link in the description. So let's see if they're up.
Good morning!
Very nice.
Very nice.
I was just showing everybody the view.
Nice view here.
Herman lived in Ekrum.
One day.
Yeah, yesterday we went, Herman showed us around and he showed us where they lived and also the places where he worked and drilled holes. And there's not a house in Ekrum that he hasn't drilled a hole in.
Many houses.
Yes.
So, what are you doing here?
I'm cleaning the mess from the coconut oil.
Ah, wow.
I spilled some coconut oil. So it looks like ice.
Wow. That was a big explosion. Yes. Yeah, Herman was making a nice dinner for us last night. And then he cooks in here, huh? With the frying pan.
Yes. Here's the frying pan. I need to clean that also.
Ah.
The princess.
And it's really handy because he has hookups here, then you don't have the smells upstairs in the living area. But you do have to be careful.
Don't put the lid on it. Directly after frying the sweet potatoes, so there's some water on the lid, and then it explodes in the frying pan.
Yeah, a very important tip of the day, because then you have to clean all of these things up. But the good thing of coconut oil is that it is easily removable.
It's getting hard, eh? When it gets colder. And it's grease.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how can you see, buddies, the storage? The light in the back, that's how deep the basement is under the living compartment. And the good stuff is in the back, I see.
Yeah.
Room for the bikes and a lot of storage up here. Wow.
For the tools.
And Herman also has a English channel now.
Yes. Living in a mobile home. It's I think I've got 5 videos on that. So when you're interested, look at Living in a Mobile Home. Then you see this how I built this mobile home, this RV, this box truck.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll put a link in the description so you can easily find it. And he could also use some subscriber buddies, of course. So feel free to go over there, check it out.
Welcome. Hi.
Hey.
Lekker zo?
Ja.
Ja.
Lekker rustig hier.
Ja.
Hello, buddy. So, we're the campus part. A line board. It has some youth in cars. If it's like this, it's okay. It doesn't really bother us. And otherwise we have to pack her up. We'll see. Yes, buddies, you always have a few options. Option one is just enjoy the music.
Yep.
Option two, I mean, if nothing else, if they start climbing on a van or trying to get in, you can always call the cops and tell them where you're at. And meanwhile, you just wait in the van. Your van is like the shell that protects you. Mm-hmm. And rather that the van gets some damage than we do. So another thing is just drive off. And Penelope is drive offable, but as a last resort, basically, because we have things in the cabin that need to go behind, and then we have to pull back the chairs to be able to drive off. So that's the last resort, but we could do it, right?
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
As always, we have to assess the situation and if they mind their business, that's fine with us. And but always you don't want to wrongly assess the situation that you're in the bed and then you have to move after all.
Dearest Petra, you are such a lovely person. I love your art. Happy holidays to you and pets. Best wishes. Oh, that's so nice. Thank you. She bought fantasy turtle. And a picture Oreo cows at the castle.
Oh, your first painting, Salt.
Yeah.
Oh. Did we call for an Uber?
Yes, we did. Our good friend Jaap is our Uber today.
A personal Uber. Now that's what we call service. How are you for today, Benny? Sheepies. I don't know if you can see them. Sheepies. Reception.
Very friendly.
Very friendly. They said we're the only guests. This is the normal camper spot. With boats. Ah, wait, beans?
Beans.
Ah, so... Yes, we got a key of the invalid toilet. Everything else is closed. They have a store that's closed too. Is it further?
Yep, further.
And
go to the field F. Field F.
Field F?
Yep.
This is field C.
This is
here.
And then straight on your left. 72. Ah, there it is. 72. Awesome.
It is grassy.
Yes, it is.
Oh, then we're sleeping with the head downwards.
Down.
So let's turn this around.
That's not comfortable.
That's not comfortable, buddy. Because we went here because it said hardened spots. So spots with what do you call it? Gravel pavement, not grass.
Yeah,
But since they have the boats on there, now we're on grass after all. We got the whole place to ourselves, and they said just pay when you check out. That's the easiest. And yeah. Frisgegeen, hè? Nah.
Nah. Awesome.
Wow, Gea is a star here.
Yes. I found a plug, buddies. Let me show you where the plug is. Here, you also have water. Don't know whether it is working, but... no. Water's off.
Closed off.
Water's
you
closed
a dump, up. I think. This is a
water.
Dump.
Water. Dump. Mm-hmm. Looks like it.
Do you wear any plugs?
And here, you see this nice little door.
Door? Is there a gnome in there?
Mm-hmm.
Anybody
is anybody
gnome?
Gnome? Yes, it's a plug. A power outlet.
Yeah.
You see? It goes all the way.
It even has TV cable hookup.
Awesome. So if you wanted to watch television.
Oh, you can see how thick the cable is.
Yes, yeah, very thick.
Very thick.
Yeah, there's the water hose, there's the electricity hose, and there's something else.
The milk is on the grass. Mm-hmm. Tire deep in the grass. But it does feel sturdy.
Firm. In your boots.
Vanilla pie. Mm-hmm. And we're at spot 70, number 72. Mm-hmm. And that's a lucky number.
Yeah. Exactly.
Why is that the lucky number?
It's my year of birth. Yes.
Oh, happy birth year day.
Yes.
Yeah, we think it brings us luck to stand at Petra's birth year, lucky number.
Let's hope so.
The Quetta nest.
Yes, it is.
This is the handicapped shower.
Yep.
There's a toilet, toilet paper, brackets, shower.
Shower? Wow.
Power outlet. I can shave, buddies.
You can shave.
I can shave.
Shave.
Mm-hmm.
Let's shave. Double lock.
No. Petra dropped the keys.
No, you did. I gave them to you and you dropped them. You dropped them like it's hot. Wow. Awesome.
The laundry room. Whoa, huge.
Five washing machines and three dryers.
This is the normal toilet building.
It's closed for the winter.
Closed for the winter.
Awesome.
That would be nice. Ah, there's you can wash your clothing. See? Clothing washing things.
Yeah.
That looked awesome.
Very awesome.
Ladies, gents. If you pay for, because they open all year, that is something that we run into sometimes, that it is open all year, and then you pay the price for all year, and then you can't use the facilities because they close them down. And in a way you would expect everything to be open if the campsites open all year, and at least the minimal necessities, and it is in this case it is because we have a key of the toilet building, but now we can't show you the regular toilet building. Mm-hmm. So you either expect the price to match the fewer access to the facilities, then you would expect the price to go down. And if the price stays the same, you expect the facilities to stay the same as well.
What did I sell? Oh yes, yes. Well, after our last video, I got an order, two orders even. One order for the turtle painting. So if you wanted to buy that or were saving up for it, you're out of luck.
It's sold out.
It's sold out, it's gone. And I got an order for...
The other ones are still available.
Yes. And I got an order for a picture, the Oreo cows with the castle. So it's coming your way. You know who you are.
Yes, you do. Are we gonna throw in a free sticker, maybe?
Yeah, maybe. As a Christmas present.
Yes. There's always a gamble if you see a spot in the app and you look at the pictures, because I saw all these places with gravel and I thought, oh, that's firm ground for Penelope. And then in reality, they put the boats on there.
Who does that?
Yes.
Well, in Akkum it was also like...
Yeah, they also did the same in Akkum, because they don't expect... Look, buddies, they have a dot in the dinges.
What? A dot in the dinges? Oh, no. Yes. A condensed dot.
When we were in Akkum, there was a lot of shells underground. And this is the result. And you can see, Petra is cleaning out the RV.
Yep.
And it's taking like 30 seconds to do so.
Another advantage of the van life.
An advantage of the van life? Mm-hmm. That your cleaning gets very easy.
Yes, very easy. Very little. Lots of shells. Just doing things. Just Well, it's all natural.
Yes.
It shows and things.
Yes.
You don't even see it anymore.
It's a symbol of good luck and fortune.
Sure.
You come in here and instantly you have wet. You take the wetness inside.
Take the mud inside.
But in a house it's basically the same thing.
Exactly the same.
And if it dries up, it's really easy to clean.
Really easy.
Because for me it's really easy, because Petra cleans it. Let's see how the view changes every time. This morning it was sheep.
Yeah.
And today it's a field.
A field and water.
Hello buddies.
Hi.
Shaving mission accomplished.
Mm-hmm.
Toilet mission accomplished.
Mm-hmm.
Shower mission. We're very cold. There's no hot water.
Nah.
What's up with that, buddies?
This is ridiculous.
Goedemiddag, Lietje in de Woude. U spreekt met Jeff.
Goeiedag, we hebben met de camper vandaag ingecheckt van jullie.
Ja.
En we wilden net even douchen, maar het zit alleen maar koud water op de douche. Dus ik weet niet of dat... normaal is?
Oh, nee, dat is niet normaal. Dan gaan we daar even naar kijken. Collega, kom langs.
Oké.
Okay. Ja, sorry voor het ongemak.
So, buddies, here we are waiting for the campsite to fix the heat water. What if we would go in the evening to shower, which we were originally planning to do? Then the reception building is closed and you cannot shower...
At all.
And then you have to wait for the next day to ask them to turn on the heat water, hot water or not.
Yeah.
So some campsites, they just don't have all their ducks in a row, for they're not expecting guests, which we think, if that's your line of business, and not to be critical or negative, but if that's your line of business, then if you open, then you can expect customers coming in.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to be prepared always for that unexpected customer, and it seems that in some places they're just not prepared for that, and it takes away from your experience of everything going seamlessly. Mm-hmm. That the electricity works as soon as you plug in, that the toilet works as you flush it, that there's toilet paper or that there's hot water or mm-hmm. just stuff that makes you stay easy and comfortable, and that's just the basic comfort needs that you pay for in the after season. And a lot of places they do it properly, they do it well, and everything works, luckily.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Definitely.
And then we have to think, well, if we would ever return here, then we have that experience of the shower being cold.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And that's what the first thing you remember then. Oh, let's go to that campsite with the beautiful views. Oh, didn't they have that cold shower there? And oh, yeah. And the toilet building was closed, the regular one. And yeah, that's just some things that you remember then that you take with you. And it can be different for everybody. If it works, then you don't even discuss it at all. So just we rang to the reception, and I said they would send somebody over. So we'll see what happens, keep you posted. Well, but it's almost an hour later. They say, oh, we sent somebody to fix it, and then they drop the ball.
No feedback, no.
Yeah, so then you're waiting, basically, you're waiting to prepare dinner until they fix it, or they let you know if they fix it. Shouldn't the receptionist know that the hot water is turned off as soon as you check in? So, it's been over almost 2 hours now. They haven't reported back to us if the shower has hot water again. So I suppose the only thing I can do is walk over there and check it again. Buddy, are you coming with me? You coming with me, buddy? She will stay warm with Petra.
Come with me. Stay with me.
So, buddy, there we go. To the misty spot. Checking out whether the hot water is turned on. Oh, here's the building again. Looks dark. Let's enter. Let's turn on the lights. And let's check. Still cold. Still cold. It's getting warmer, buddies. It's warm. Warmth. Let's tell Petra the good news. Captain to Space Shuttle, over.
Space Shuttle here, over.
We have hot water, over, hot water, over.
Awesome!
I'm coming back to the moon lander. Over.
Moon lander, here, over.
We have our walkie-talkie guidance our docking system, and it's color-based, so you can switch channels, different colors, as you can see. And then we just find a channel that works, and to talk we have to have the same channel. We have to be tuned in to the same channel, and sometimes you have like interference and then you switch to another color. And at least we can shower. It's a bit of a shame that they didn't report back to us, but it seems they did fix it immediately. So that's one less thing to worry about. Hello, buddies, there I am again.
Back in the Moonlander.
I was talking to you guys when the camera shut off. It's on low power. Battery is about to go out, so we have to end this video. Stay tuned, go Christmas shopping, artups.com/rvlicious, or go to patreon.com/rvlicious to support us.
Yes, only 3 paintings available. Turtle is gone.